Today we're going to take a look at our motion detected MP3 setup and trigger sounds with our Redboard Qwiic Arduino. If you haven't used the Qwiic Connect here, it's definitely worth checking out. If you're brand new to it, stick around and we will get this board up and running in no time. Previously, we used the regular Redboard and the MP3 player shield on top of that, and a momentary push button, and the HCSR501 PIR sensor. But today we're going to set that aside, and we're going to use, of course, the same MP3 player shield. We're going to use the Redboard Qwiic Arduino with the Qwiic Connect right here. I'm going to use a Qwiic button. The tactile button, and we'll use the SparkFun Qwiic PIR, the passive infrared sensor made by Panasonic, and we'll have a couple of our Qwiic Connect cables, and that's all we'll need. The first thing we're going to do is go to the SparkFun website and download our driver for this board, and you go to this, and I will link this in the description. So at this web page, you just scroll down to the download here, the executable file. And now we're going to download the CH341 SER executable file. Click on that, download it. Then you're going to open it up and you install it. Then you're going to get a screen that looks like this. You're going to click on uninstall to uninstall anything you may have on there, an old version or whatever. Then you click on install. Then you install the CH341SER.INF. That's the proper driver that you need. Next thing we'll do is plug our board in and check to see that the driver is properly installed by going to the device manager on our computer and then coming down to ports, COM and LPT, and open it up and you should see USB serial, CH340, and the COM that it's associated with. And there's also another way. You can just open up your Arduino IDE, which you'll do anyway. And you can come up here, and then you can see Arduino Uno COM9. Come down here, and then you'll see COM9 serial port, USB. So everything looks good so far. The next thing we're going to do is go to arduino.cc, click on software. From here, we can download the Arduino IDE, the 2.2 version, 2.2.1. This is the Arduino Integrated Development Environment, the open source IDE. It connects to the Arduino hardware and it's how you will communicate with them. It's also where you're going to write, edit, and upload your programs. So here's the Redboard, the one we've been using. And here is the Qwiic board. I was going to say new board, it's new to me. This is the Qwiic board. There's a little bit of a difference between the two. The old board used the mini connection, the USB mini. And the new board, or the Qwiic board, uses the USB micro connection. And also, if you look on the top here, this is the AP2112 voltage regulator. That's a 3.3 volt regulator, and it can source up to 600 milliamps of power. And that'll help you daisy chain your Qwiic connected devices from the Qwiic connector right here. And you'll notice that this is a very small 4-pin 1mm JST connector, and that is common on all the Qwiic-based boards. And this is how you're going to create your own I2C-based device, which is compatible within the Qwiic system. And right here we have voltage level jumpers, 3.3 volt and 5 volt. And this allows the user to convert the board and the I/O pins to either 3.3 volt or 5 volt based on your project and what you need. I thought that was pretty neat as well. So let's go ahead and put the MP3 player shield on top. Now that we've got our MP3 player shield attached to our board, we are going to go ahead and take a look at the button. Here is our Qwiic button. It is a 12mm red LED button. It's rated for 50 milliamp, and it's got a built-in LED, and you can configure that to blink, to be dim, or whatever you want. Each button has a configurable I2C address, so you can have multiple buttons in your daisy chain. It has configurable interrupts, and if you don't like red, they have it in multiple colors. They have red, blue, green, white. You can even buy your own blank breakout board. You can put your own button on here. This is the Qwiic PIR sensor, or passive infrared sensor, and there are two options here, the 170 microamp or the 1 microamp, and this is the 1 microamp. The 170 microamp is ideal for continuous powered applications. This one is ideal for battery powered applications. The AT-Tiny84IC is what handles the raw sensor output. It also debounces output, it triggers interrupts, and manages a queue of sensing events. And on the back you'll see some solder jumpers. There are four of them: the power, the I2C, the interrupt, and the address. The PWR controls the power LED, the I2C, and the INT, the interrupt. Those jumpers manage pull-up resistors. The ADR, which is the address, that jumper sets the I2C address. Now I'm holding the Qwiic sensor here next to the very popular HCSR501 motion sensor, and you can tell that it's lower profile. It's going to be easier to hide in your projects. That's one reason I like this so much. Here's some data I found on the SparkFun website about this sensor. Now the operating voltage for the 170 microamp version is a little bit higher than the 1 microamp version. For the 170 microamp version, it's a minimum operating voltage of 3 and a max of 6 volts. For the 1 microamp version, a minimum voltage of 2.3 and a max of 4. It may also be useful to know the detection range of this sensor. It can go up to 7 meters, but your more reliable range is going to be right around 5 meters. And this motion sensor was designed to detect the human body moving at a speed of about 1 meter per second. Here's a look at the Qwiic cables with that JST connector at the tip. Now there's really only going to be one way you can put this in the connector on the board, and all the Qwiic cables have the same color scheme. Black is ground, red is 3.3 volt, blue is SDA, yellow is SCL, and that's what's going to give you your I2C connection for your devices. Now we're just going to connect our devices, each one. We're going to connect the motion sensor, and we're going to connect that to the button. We're going to daisy chain it out from the microcontroller. And it's going to give us a lot more room, a lot more flexibility with our projects, which is what I really like. And the cables help keep it nice and clean. It's very easy to manage. I really like this system. Here's a look at the code real quick. We can see at the top that the libraries are added for various functionalities for this project, and you can see those listed there. We see the object button and PIR. They're defined for the Qwiic button and the Qwiic PIR motion sensor. The objects SD and MP3 player, those are for the SD card and the MP3 player shield. The motion mode is a Boolean flag indicating the system is in motion sensor mode. And the last change time and last track play time, those are timestamps for mode change and track play events. Then the mode change delay and the track play delay are constants that define the delay durations. In the setup, we see serial communication set at 11,5200 baud rate. The Qwiic devices, the motion sensor and button are initialized. The SD card is initialized with multiple attempts, there's 5 attempts, and half speed SPI communication. The MP3 player is initialized and the volume is set. And the system is initialized in the motion sensor mode and a random seed is set using the analog read 0. In the loop, we see the button press is checked to toggle between motion sensor mode and random MP3 file selection mode. And if the button is pressed and that delay is elapsed, then the mode is toggled. And we also set the LED on the button to come on during the random MP3 file selection mode. In the motion sensor mode, if the motion is detected, a message is printed, and a random track is selected between 1 and 6. I have 6 MP3 files on there. And in the random MP3 file selection mode, after 5 seconds has elapsed, that's my delay, another random track between 1 and 6 is played. So basically this program allows for two modes, the playing a random MP3 track when motion is detected, or toggle to continuously play random MP3 tracks between 5 second delays. And we use the Qwiic button to toggle back and forth. Now I'm going to go ahead and plug the audio jack from my speakers into the MP3 player shield. Then I'm going to plug in my USB from the computer to the Redboard, or the Red Qwiic board. Alright. And if you don't know how to set up the MP3 player shield, make sure you check out our first video on that. You'll see how to format the MP3 files and make it a lot easier for you. Make sure to check the description for the video link. Now it's time to upload the code to our board. And then we'll open the serial monitor to see what it says. And it says motion sensor mode activated, so we're good. It should work now. When the sensor detects motion, it should play a song. I give it a little bit of time to reset. I'll do it again. The red light is on the button. That means it's no longer in motion detection mode. It is in random MP3 file selection mode every 5 seconds. Thank you for watching. If you found this useful, be sure to like and subscribe and share it with somebody else who may find it useful. See you again soon.